And now I would like to hand over to Enrica Bosani, who will be presenting the successful use case for today's session. Thank you, Enrica.
Thank you very much, Julia. I share my screen. Welcome to the presentation of the Whirlpool use case that really in a very, very synthetic way describe the possibility to use the Koala platform, so the Koala solution, in order to support the quality control in a laboratory that we have at the end of the assembly line, where we execute a statistical control on aesthetical and functional part of a product, microwave in particular way we're speaking about. So the intention that was behind this use case is not only to create for the workers an active support, helping them to go through the checklist execution, but also offering the possibility to have a predictive quality analytics result that may be used in order to make the checklist, the control checklist of the operators dynamical instead of statical. So now we have checklists that are defined at the beginning of when we launch a product. In this case, the idea was really to leverage on Koala predictive and prescriptive functionalities in order to boost the quality continuous improvement process management in the shop floor. So we have fundamentally within the use case two main scenarios. One dedicated to the operator, that is our key stakeholder in the exercise. Currently, the operator execute the checklist by memory. So the checklists are written on paper, are learned by the workers. And when generally they are very expert users that by memory go through the checklist, execute the control and identify the defect that are notified to legacy systems. With Koala, the workers demonstrated the possibility to be facilitated in executing the checklist, being guided step by step in what has to be done. Not only, but also having the possibility to get recommendation that comes out from predictive and prescriptive analytics functionalities in order to suggest actions, control actions dedicated to that specific product that is in front of them in a specific moment. Depending from the analytics result that are executed on quality data of that product. And this is very powerful possibility for the person. Another important element that have been driven into the use case for the operator is the possibility to lead the operator through a learning process. So differentiating the level of detail that is used to describe the operations that has to be executed according to the different skills of the operator themselves, so novice, intermediate, or expert. The second scenario is mainly dedicated to the supervisor of the laboratory, quality laboratory, that in this case currently fundamentally execute manually the analysis on quality data. For sure, a lot of data, complex analysis, complex application of statistical tools make for him difficult to be proactive in the approach to the quality and defect detection in particular way. With Koala, he has the possibility not only to control and manage the composition of the checklist and support better the operator, his workers in go up and running and achieve the target related to efficiency and effectiveness in the quality control. But he may also get access to a quality risk assessment analytics result that may offer to him and to the overall Whirlpool organization the possibility really to anticipate the possibility to have the effect and put in place the actions that not only detect but may be resolved in advance with an early management, the defect that may impact on the production that is delivered by the factory. This is a very important functionality, so root cause analysis, Y-Engine, are really important tools that are offered and to the supervisor in order really to get an important impact from business point of view out of the application of these type of technologies. Which are the challenges that we drove into the use case? So when we approach Koala for the first time, for sure one of the key elements that we had the need to address was related to complexity. A huge amount of data, complex analysis that has to be run, so something that is difficult to be managed manually with the standard or traditional tool by the quality managers. And we had in mind the need to pass from a reactive approach to quality and defect detection to a proactive approach. So the for sure the predictive analytics functionalities that Koala offer are for sure important in order to enable this proactivity in managing the quality issue. For sure, another important challenge that we were driving is that, in particular in the quality control for aesthetical defects, the expertise of the workers was a bottleneck. So the possibility to create a sort of digital twin of the knowledge of the person, ensuring also to novice the possibility to be guided and to learn how to execute this complex test, was really very, very important, very, very important for us. And also the learning process was something that was very difficult to be managed and controlled at the show floor. Koala is offering not only to the workers, but also to the supervisor, the possibility to speed up this process and to make the best and the most out of this type of experience. For us, so the motivation, these were the challenges. What was driving us into the project? First of all, the idea to validate through Koala the positive effect that may be introduced in a factory by the digital assistance technologies. And this is very important because for us, this technology was at a certain point of view very risky because it was touching the privacy, touching something that was strictly related to GDPR and so on. So for sure, it was an experience that was driving us in verifying the applicability of this technology in specific cases within the shop floor. Also, the idea was also to use this technology in order to support, first of all, the quality control and the quality management in the factory, but in particular way to leverage on the skills and competencies of the person in order to make the best out of the application of this type of solution. Also, the predictive analytics functionalities was very attractive for us because as most of the industrial companies, we have a lot of huge amount of data, quality data, and we are not really able to use fully them in order to take a best and better decision to act and to resolve in advance, so proactively, the potential quality issue. Also the topic related to the privacy management related to this type of technologies that generally use personal data is something that is pretty new in the industry and was for sure a challenge for us. It was an important motivation that drove us in really applying the exercise at the best in order to be sure that we can create a foundation that opened the door to the factory for the next implementation. So that's the reason why also we were strongly convinced that the change management action that has to support the introduction of this type of technology is one of the elements that would have been further investigated. So it's worth pay attention on that because the communication actions, the training action, and everything that has to be related to the preparation of the person, of the organization for this type of technology introduction was very crucial for us. What we achieved, so where we are now. Now, as was mentioned before, we are pretty near to the completion of the project. We had several demo sessions when the users used the system, tested the trial, provided us feedback, helped us to develop, resolve, improve the platform that has been produced. And at the moment, we can say that we achieved several important elements that was part of our motivation at the beginning. So first of all, we got the final confirmation that the voice worker assistance technology is absolutely valid and important, so has a huge potential for the application in industry, not only in, let me say, offline activities like, for example, quality control in a laboratory, but also potentially in online activities, in quality control in the assembly line, or, for example, supporting the workers in complex activity execution. For sure, the equipment that have to be offered to the workers for to make the best out of this experience have to be probably better defined. So maybe the tablet are not the best solution. Other wearable device like headphone or touch screen probably are better fitting to the constraint of a working environment. But I think that after the experience, we find for sure a formal approval, a validation by the users that have been very happy to use and see a big potential in the application of this solution. It was very important also the possibility to manage the level of competence of the operator, even if in the full respect of the privacy of the person, and also the possibility to pass from a novice level to an expert level is something that has been remarked as very, very positive by the users. And the same was for the predictive quality functionalities. So the quality risk assessment, so the possibility to identify a level of risk, quality risk in a product according to a predictive analytics, is something that has been very appreciated by the workers and also by the supervisors, because this is really a key enabler for the future in order to boost the possibility to improve the quality, process and product quality in the factory. In this perspective, also the prescriptive analytics has been fully validated and appreciated by the users. So the possibility to link the quality risk to recommendations that the system is capable to suggest in order to early detect the potential defect is something that has been identified as very, very interesting and capable to enable the proactivity that we were looking for. Last but not least, for us, through Koala, achieved the fully, awareness about what privacy data management for this type of technology means at the shop floor, and how we can be fully compliant with the GDPR policies related to that. This is really pretty important because it was not easy. There were a lot of constraints, and at the end we discovered a lot of new things that have not to be ignored during the digital transformation, because otherwise we risk to arrive to bottlenecks that cannot be overcome. So it's important to set up a well-defined and structured change management in order to enable the users the possibility to be fully aware about the potential and the risk of this technology, and being capable to accept and adopt in a very easy and fast way this type of solution. For sure, in this moment, not everything has been resolved. There are still challenges that are open, are in place, and will be dealt in the next Wasabi project. So for sure, Wasabi will take the heritage of Koala and will continue and resolve also this type of elements. As first, for sure, the element related to the quality of the data that have to be used for the predictive analytics. This is something that we suspected at the beginning, but any industrial company, we have a lot of data with very, very poor quality most part of the time, and so it's not fit for a good practice in predictive analytics. So the result is not so good, mainly due to the fact that our quality data set are not so good. So that's one of the important points. So being aware of that, drove a Whirlpool organization to rethink a bit to the strategy that you are putting in place from a data management point of view and architectural data, in particular way in cloud solution. This is absolutely important, an important learning for us. Another point that for sure it's a challenge is the weakness that has been driven by the system integration constraint that we had. For sure, the research project creates sometimes difficulties in having the possibility really to be fully integrated in compliance, in full compliance with the security policies in big companies like we are. This created some troubles, and in some cases, the integration is still weak in this moment. And the same can be said for some functionalities that are not fully mature, in particular way for what concerns the possibility to explain, for example, in root cause analysis, the explanation to the user is not so user-friendly. So for sure, a refinement activity through Wasabi will be put in place in order to arrive at a solution that really may do something more and something more efficient for the users that will take the advantage of this platform. Last but not least, some of these weaknesses impacted on the possibility for us to use continuously the system. We had several demo sessions, but limited in terms of time. So we had not the possibility till now to have a real impact on business KPIs that for sure can be detected only with a mid long term perspective, so in longer time horizon. For sure, this is something that we will work on for the next phase with the support of the solution that will be developed in Wasabi project. And so for us, the key lesson learned and recommendation are more or less summarized here and repeat what I've already mentioned before. So for an industrial company in this type of project, it's crucial to count on a robust, solid, and high quality data set in order to be sure that the predictive and prescriptive analytics is capable really to provide in efficient and effective way the results to the user. GDPR, it's important, is difficult to be achieved, has to be defined by design into the platform, and Koala did it. But what we experience is that the users have a very, very low level of awareness about the risks that this type of technologies, voice assistance in particular way, has. That's the reason why it's important to put in place a structured change management, communication and training effort in order to be sure that they are aware about the risk. And this is absolutely respectful towards the workers. So it's absolutely important, cannot be skipped. System integration, as I mentioned before, is an important and crucial point, has to be addressed. And probably so is something that have to be delayed to the finalization of the Koala version for markets. So it's not something that probably is proper to address during a research project development, and we learn that. So for the next time, for sure, we will do something different. For sure, the equipment and also we discovered this element that have to be used are different from the ones that we had in mind since the beginning. So much better to leverage on wearable devices, touch screen with high wider screen for visualization instead of tablets, because in this moment, the tablets are anyway tools that in the factory are difficult to be used. So for sure, this is something that have to be resolved in the future solution of Koala. And last but not least, for sure, we have a full confirmation about the validity of this type of technology, worker assistance technology in the shop floor. So the expectation is that Wasabi and the other project will drive a Koala solution to higher TRL to be really capable to offer into the market a solution that can be really used by industry like we are. Thank you very much. I completed. If there are questions, more than welcome. I will be happy to answer at the end of the presentations.